product manager for a company known as Simpa Networks. Simpa is a social enterprise. So we work for a mission. We work to provide energy access to people who do not have it or need it the most. A typical customer for Simpa is someone who does not have energy at all or has it for less than 6 hours on a daily basis. And we try to reach them and we try to sell them a product and we also try to make a profit out of it. This talk is about that, but before I go into what we do, I just want to share a couple of stories. The first story is from Mathura in Uttar Pradesh. Mathura is also the birthplace of Lord Krishna, but the story is not about Lord Krishna. The story is about energy poverty and loss of opportunity. And this is Mathura railway station on 30th of May this year. On 30th of May, Mathura was extremely hot. It was 45 degrees centigrade, but the train was late as usual, and I was waiting for the train, and what I wanted was a cool drink of water. So I walked up to the shop and I asked them, can you give me a bottle of water? He said, well, I could sell it to you, but you won't be able to drink it because the water is so hot. Here I see a loss of opportunity. In a selfish way, I didn't get the water. But for the shop owner, he could not sell, he could not make money, and there is money trapped in form of inventory. And by the way, this is central Mathura. This is right in the center of the town. Let me take you further away, 35 kilometers away, to a village called Bankarpur Masela. Funny name. So this is my co-researcher, auto driver, navigator, Virendra, taking me to Bankarpur Basela, where I meet a bunch of families, and I particularly get interested in this person called Arav Singh and his family. Arav Singh is extremely frustrated with his energy situation. He gets less than 8 hours electricity, like sometimes less than six, and he's got three kids. He lives with his wife, his mother and father. He was extremely frustrated and wanted to change his situation. He has seen things that are available in the local market in the village, so there's a bunch of stuff that we can buy from there, but this wouldn't work. It would conk off in a couple of months, and it's sort of temporary. He's not interested in that solution. There are more high-end solutions available if he goes further away to Mathura town, and it's a conventional inverter and a battery combination, something that we use in Bangalore also often. But this is not designed for rural India. It is designed for a minimum of 12 hours of power supply every day. And if you power it with less than 12 hours of power supply, this is a common sight. You take it back to the town to get it fixed. And Arav Singh did not want to get into that hassle. He's got three growing kids. The guy's got a very progressive mindset. I take you back to his older picture. And you can see there's a tractor in the background, there is a motorbike. Arav Singh's not exactly poor. He stays in a village, but he's sort of prosperous. So he's got money to buy something. He's interested. He's got growing kids. He's caring about them. He sends them to private school, invests a fair bit in them. He wants them to see a life that he has not seen. And he wanted energy solutions mainly for that. But he lives his life every night in a dim, dangerous, dirty kerosene lamp. He just stays like this. So why does that happen to Arav Singh? And from here on, I'll explain what Simpa as an organization does for people in villages and how we try to use user experience at a business model level to overcome these challenges. So the picture says buy real panel only. Most of these customers, even Arav Singh had heard about solar. But he did not know what to buy really because he had lack of guidance. That's a problem that we face on a daily basis. And there are many others that I talked about. But there's always, if you look deeper and harder and stay with the customers, there is always a way to make happy customers. That's what we feel. And that's what we strive for. So we have made a network of energy friends. We call them Urja Mitras. We have a network of more than 2,000 energy friends in villages where we operate. So these are our ambassadors who learn from us, get coaching on how solar is good for villagers. They adopt them, and they also believe that adopting solar will help the village to change at large. And they become our ambassadors, and they take this information back to villages. So we build trust with our customers. And then once if someone buys, we send technicians at the doorstep and give a very customized installation. Where do you want the panel? Where do you want the lights? Where do you want the fan? Where do you want the mobile charging to be? All of that is done in a customized way. After all, a solar home system is a technical product. Something might fail in a few months, and Arav Singh doesn't want to go back to the town to get it fixed. So we send service technicians that are trained by the organization to go wherever it takes and to fix the system at the doorstep. That's the kind of service that we require to give in order to get someone like Arav Singh to buy a system. You might be thinking all of this is sounds all right, but it must be expensive, right? It always is. It's a good quality product. And this additional service, and you hear the customers, you've got a team. And this picture actually is 1,000 rupees paid by a certain customer to us in coins. We clearly had to break a few piggy banks to get there. And that's the reality in life. Even Arav Singh, although he has a tractor, does not have money at all times in his across the year. There's harvest season and he makes money and then he saves it for the rest of the time. And Simpa has, what Simpa has done is created this prepaid metering technology that allows you to use energy on the go. So you don't pay for the entire system upfront, but you pay about 20% of the down payment at the beginning, and over the span of next 2 or 3 years, you pay the remaining amount, like a recharge on the phone, as simple as that. So customers make a down payment, get the installations done, start using the system, keep making recharges, and when the final recharge is done at the end of 2 years, they own the system themselves. So each piece of payment also adds up to ownership of that system. The system unlocks at the end of this 2 year time period, but the opportunity is unlocked right at the beginning, on the day the installation happens at customer location. But of course, all of this is great, and there's a lot deeper diving that we need to do to improve our product as well. And I'll just take one example before I close the talk. There's some more to go, sorry. So we do extensive testing in villages. These are fans sourced from best of the suppliers from across the world. We take them to villages, and we show it to people. But my colleague over here is so finicky that he believes that appearance of the fan is actually giving the results. It's not the airflow which is telling us. So he got customers to see the fans, rate them, and said, wait, put a blindfold. And then he shuffled the fans around and said, okay, do the rating again. I want to see if you are consistent or not. That's the kind of level of detailing that we go into to make sure that for the same amount of money that we need to pay anyway, we get the best possible fan and give it to our customers. And all of this is clearly making a difference. I have a couple of customer stories over here. One of the most moving ones that I've seen is that of Bhupram. Bhupram lives in Mada in Bareilly in Uttar Pradesh, and his village has had electricity for 15 years. But he decided not to buy the electricity connection. He says the electricity is so unreliable anyway that I'd rather not buy it. But in the background you see his daughter growing up. His story is similar to Arav Singh's. He's caring about her. So one fine day he went to the market, bought a bunch of cables, brought them back home, and he had decided to buy the electricity connection. But just about the time that he was taking this decision, he heard about Simpa Energy and bought our solar system. I happened to meet this guy and asked him, why Simpa? Why not the other connection? He says, your system gives me the freedom to switch my light on when I need it, not when the government wants me to. That's one story. On the same day, I meet another person called Wasim Ahmed, a little further away in Bareilly. And Wasim Ahmed is a fruit seller. He's using those two lights and a fan in the background. And he says fruits, which he did earlier, used to shut his shop at 8 p.m. before buying the system. After buying the system, he is shutting his shop at 11 p.m. Now this extra 3 hours allows him to make 200 rupees extra every night. For a system that costs him 25 rupees on a daily basis, he's making 200 rupees every day. That's the kind of impact that you could make in, for families in rural India. In the last year alone, more than 5,000 families have adopted solar home systems designed by Simpa Energy. Rural families are big. Let's count a minimum of 5 people in every family. That means 25,000 people impacted. And there's many more. There's 600 million more in Africa. And it's not as if these numbers are going to change much, because as we power more ACs and as coal is getting over, that situation in the village is not going to improve anytime soon. Okay, so So that's the scale of the problem that we are looking at. And it's the scale of a problem if you look at it in one way. At the other end, it's the scale of an opportunity as well. What we are doing at Simpa today, maybe it's just the tip of an iceberg, and maybe not. Maybe it is a cool drink of water in Mathura sometime in the future. Imagine the impact. Thank you.